In tonight's session 2014, the controversy over minimum wage rages on. This time, though, in an attempt to get to the facts of how such a move might impact the state, the Maryland Foundation for Research and Economic Education, or Maryland FREE, commissioned an impact report. 11 News reporter Lisa Robinson has the latest from Northwest Baltimore.
Well, the authors of that study are not saying that raising the minimum wage is a bad thing, but what they are saying is no matter where you stand on the issue, you need to know the facts of what the costs are. These Wendy's employees are part of Daveco Restaurants. Dave Norman is the president of the group that operates 105 Wendy's in Maryland, employing some 3,500 people. 2,800 of his employees are hourly workers, averaging more than $8 an hour. He says raising minimum wage would be costly.
We're going to have to raise prices to offset the additional cost. And when you raise prices, you drive customers away.
Raise Maryland supports a minimum wage bill that would bring the current $7.25 an hour to $8.25 this July, $9 in 2015, and $10.10 in 2016. Dr. Stephen Fuller, a professor for George Mason University, helped prepare this study on the impact of raising the minimum wage on the Maryland economy. He says the impact would be concentrated in four major industries.
Retail trade, the hospitality sector, mainly food services, but hotel services and recreation, the healthcare sector, and construction. Those employ about 60% of the workers who would be benefited.
Fuller says the raise would mean higher prices and cost some jobs among low-wage workers, and his study says that 60% who get minimum wage are under the age of 25, mostly part-time workers and students. Larry Stottlemyre employs about 130 people in the summer at Adventure Park USA. He says he won't pay teenagers $10 an hour. He'll find older, more experienced workers.
I just can't afford to pay entry-level people and train them where they're working four months out of the summer, most of them, and spend that kind of money to train somebody and for them to leave me in 4 months and go off to college.
Now, Fuller says the study also reveals that raising the minimum wage would discourage business investment in the state. Reporting live, Lisa Robinson, WBAL-TV 11 News.